sorry. Can you hear me now? Thumbs up, Andrew? Okay, good. Thank you. Okay. So last week, the message was on what is sin. Anybody remember the definition? What is sin? Sin is anything that prevents me from loving God. Sin is anything that prevents me from loving God. So, I want to ask you, this week, have you guys thought about sin at all? This week? Teacher Jim, have you had a chance to think about sin this week? Alright. Are you serious about sin? Or sin is like something that's of no importance to you, like, who cares? How many of you take sin seriously? How many of you actively think about sin? The title of message today is Detect and Hate Sin. Detect and Hate Sin. We're gonna read from the Book of Psalms. Okay? I want you to get out your Bible. Psalms. We're gonna read from Psalm 36, verses 1 and 2. Psalm 36, verses 1 and 2. Just a little bit. So here we go. Psalm 36, verses 1 and 2. I have a message from God in my heart concerning the sinfulness of the wicked. There is no fear of God before their eyes. In their eyes, in their own eyes, they flatter themselves. Too much to detect or hate their sin. In every version, let me read that last portion again. In their own eyes, they flatter themselves too much to detect or hate. You know, God commands commands us to do a lot of things in the Bible. God commands us to love. God commands us to forgive. God commands us to take care of, to serve. But rarely does it command us to hate anything. In fact, I only know one. That is, hate sin. In today's passage, we are commanded to hate sin. Why do you think that is? We talked about sin last week. Why do you think God commands us to hate sin? Well, because if you just think about the definition, because it separates us from God. God hates sin because of sin, we are separated from God. And God doesn't want us to be separated from himself. In fact, he died, so we are not separated from himself. Sin, if it's found in us, if it remains in us, it's going to make us drift away from God. That's why God hates it, and God commands us also to hate it. Because the effects of sin in all of our life is deadly. It's cancerous. Because the consequence of sin is fatal. Let's look at some of the effects of sin, shall we? Okay, the first deadly effect of sin. What sin does to you. Well, I don't like to really use this word, and I don't like it when Daniel uses this word, but sometimes you just have to call it what it is. The first effect is that sin makes us stupid. Now, when I say the word stupid, what do you think of? The definition goes like this: having or showing a great lack of intelligence or common sense. Because basically, if you're stupid, that means the thing you should know that are common sense, that things that are obvious, you don't know. Okay? So, when I say that sin makes us stupid, I'm saying that sin blinds our minds to the obvious things, to the things that are common sense, so that you things in life. For one, sin makes us think that our life is ours, that it belongs to me, and I am free to do as I will. How many of you have similar thoughts? How many of you think it's my life, I'll do as I please? No one, I mean no one, caused themselves to exist. How many of you chose to be born? How many of you were in the spiritual realm and said, you know what, I want to be born. And I want to be born the way I look now. Jimmy, do you want to be born exactly the way you look now? Alright, good. How many of you chose your parents? Would you guys have chosen your parents? I said, oh, I see all this. I want to be born to that family. No one did that. You know, we all find ourselves in this miracle called life. We think that our life, which we had no part in starting, somehow belongs to us, that it belongs to me, that it's for my use or abuse, that I could do as I please. You know, we know perfectly well that we have no control of what happens after our death, do we? No one in this world knows exactly what's going to happen or has even a control of what happens. Just like how we had no control of our birth. Sin makes us think that we own our lives, when we actually don't. Sin fails us to believe that we are the gods of our life, that we are the master of my existence, where we're not. Secondly, sin fools us to thing that the temporal things, the temporary things of this world gives us our worth. It defines who we are. That they are what counts. What neighborhood you live, what car you drive, what grades you get in school, what college you get into, what kind of job you have. Things like that. The world fools us to think that those are the really, really important things in life. When we know that they are only temporary. Sin fools us to value these temporary things over eternal things, the things that will last forever and ever. I remember the time when 10 years ago, about 10 years ago, when I heard on the news when I was driving that Steve Jobs died. Do you know who Steve Jobs is? Really? Wow, I'm surprised. Okay, for those of you who don't know who he is, it'd be like equivalent to saying if Bill Gates died today. You know, I'm driving and I hear on the news, Bill Gates died or something like that. So back then, Steve Jobs was that person, you know, quality maker of iPhone, and he innovated the whole technology and all the hype. But you know, there's only one question in my mind when I heard that news. My one thought was, I wonder if he's a Christian. And it didn't matter what he did. It didn't matter what he didn't do. For Steve, at that particular moment, the only thing that mattered in his entire existence and universes if he believes in God, because he's in front of God's judgment. It doesn't matter how vast, how great things that we do here on this earth is only temporary. And it's non-relevant for eternal life. Sin makes us stupid to just focus on the temporary things of the world when what is really important is the eternal things of our existence. Amen? Jesus Christ said, what shall we gain a man if he shall gain the whole world what's important. The eternal things of life. But sin blinds us to that obvious fact. Some of us might be listening to the message and we're still blind. I don't care. I'm just going to live for today. Thirdly, sin fools us to think that we can mix two things that just cannot be mixed together. Sin fools us to think that we can mix light and darkness, the holy things of God and the unholy things of the world, God's will and my will. Sin fools us to think that a worldly Christian or a part-time Christian, a Sunday Christian, is still a Christian. Even though we know that God's word that tells us that no one can serve two masters, that lukewarm Christian is not a real Christian, and that God says that he's going to spit them out of his mouth. We know this. We read this. But we still